Hey guys, what's going on? Andrew coming at you, and here are 7 reasons Swedes don't like you. I got inspired by this idea from Rope Trotting. I haven't watched the video, I just saw the title, thought it was fantastic, so I'm gonna link his original video below so you can watch it after mine. Go give his channel some love. Number one has to be bragging. See, this has to do with something called Jantelagen, which basically means here in Sweden that, like, you're not better than anyone else, you shouldn't act like you're better than anyone else, you shouldn't show off, and it's such a big part of the culture that, like, taking any credit or being overly confident in Sweden is something that Swedes mostly avoid. Like, if you go up to a Swede and you say to a Swede, like, hey, excellent job at work, they'll probably just say, well, it's my job. Like, if you try to give them credit, that's kind of how they'll be, because they almost have to be so modest. We're in the States, sometimes we can brag. Americans are confident, and we're not afraid to be confident, and sometimes, maybe in Sweden, that can come across as being bragging. Number two has to be being loud. You know, a lot of Americans and other cultures, we can be loud. In English, like, one person keeps talking, then another person's talking, so you're talking over each other. And actually, when I go back to the States, I go through reverse culture shock, because if I'm in Europe, I can spot the Americans from a mile away because they're talking much louder, and we don't really realize how loud we talk in English until we're in another country where it's not as loud. So if you're being overly loud, Swedes are probably not gonna like you. Number three has to be littering or not recycling. You're gonna annoy anyone if you litter. You shouldn't do it. We take care of the streets here. I mean, maybe Friday, Saturday night, people smoke cigarettes and those are thrown on the ground. But yeah, you shouldn't just litter. And I think if you did litter in front of a Swede, they would call you out in a second and ask you to pick it up, especially an older Swedish lady. They're gonna tell you how it is here in Sweden. Number four has to be giving your opinions. You know, Swedes are so, they keep their opinions to themselves in a lot of cases, like, especially personal things, politics, things that are like really deep thinking things is only for Swedes' close friends. A lot of times Americans, we can tend to like not be afraid to give you our opinions. We'll talk about a lot of controversial topics and issues, and we're just super opinionated. And I think sometimes that can be a bit much for a Swede that either doesn't want to get into those conversations with you, especially sober in those situations. That might be like a Swede bar conversation they feel more comfortable where Americans just go ahead and give our opinions. So sometimes we gotta keep our opinions back. I mean, look at me, I got my own YouTube channel giving my opinions, right? I couldn't just keep it to myself. Number five, being critical of Sweden. Now, Swedes will never say this to you, but if you are in Sweden and you're a foreigner, you should never be critical of Sweden. Swedes will just not like it, even if it's just a difference in opinions. Swedes take a lot of pride in their country. It's silent patriotism where they don't like rub it in your face. We're not like America where we have the flags all the time and fireworks, but they are extremely self-conscious as a country, and they care very much about how they're seen internationally, and if they're not seen well, they are really sensitive towards that. So it's just something I've noticed, that Swedes are not a fan of criticism, where I feel like Americans, we're used to people kind of criticizing America, even we do it ourselves, that we kind of laugh at ourselves. But yeah, that's my own opinion on that one. Number six has to be being late. Swedes love to do everything on time, but you're not supposed to get there early though, as well. So if you're invited to a party at 7, it starts at 7, and they got stuff planned. There's usually Swedish parties have like icebreaker games, and everything is planned to a T a lot of the times, as opposed to just being like people start talking and mingling. It's usually planned mingling. So you gotta get there on time, you gotta be there on time. In Sweden, we'll walk around the block a couple times just to get there right at 7 instead of early, if I'm too early. And then the other end is sometimes in America, you can be fashionably late to a party because you know that it's fine to get there a little bit after it starts. But in Sweden, that's not the case. You gotta come on time. If you're late, that's gonna make a Swede mad. And then number 7 has to be, if you don't pay your taxes. You know, in Sweden, if you don't take care of your health, there's a big thing with personal responsibility here in Sweden. And if you don't take care of your own health and you don't pay your fair wage here in Sweden, you will be looked down upon. You will be publicly shamed. You must pay your taxes. If you believe in the Swedish system, but at the same time, you want to get out of the taxes that Swedes pay, that is looked down upon. Although there will be wealthy people here in Sweden who typically might move to Switzerland if their company gets very successful, it is something that's known, because in Sweden, if you are a billionaire or super successful, you have to pay a lot of high taxes. But it's interesting in Sweden because Sweden has more millionaires per capita than the United States. So it seems to be people are still able to be extremely wealthy, they're just maybe not wealthy enough to fire rockets into space and look down at Earth with, like, so much joy. But anyways, that's my list here, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please go ahead and smash that like button. Is there anything I missed that you just hate as a Swede? Let me know, and I'll talk about it maybe in the next video. You never know. All right, guys. I'll see you. Hey,